Salutations. I'm Jessico, and you're watching Game Dev Made Easy. In the video today, we are going to look at how to change the time of day settings in CryEngine. I know many aspects of CryEngine can be very cryptic and hard to figure out, as when you do a search for information, CryEngine 3 documentation appears before CryEngine 5.5, and even if you do find CryEngine 5.5, they tend to focus more on how to do things like this via flow graph. So let's rectify that and make it so that you know how to do this multiple ways. There are four ways we can change the time of day settings. The first and easiest way is to manually change it in the environment editor. The second method is to modify the XML file that stores the information that the engine reads from. The third way is via code with C++ or C#. The approach is very similar between them. And the fourth way is to handle it via flow graph. Let's create a new project in CryEngine. Mine will be the third-person template with C#, just so that we have things on screen and see how things are affected, and I will call the project Time of Day Tutorial. So while things are getting set up, I should note that the time of day settings handles things similar to how you expect things to occur in the real world. This means that CryEngine's time of day settings are controlled based on 24-hour time. The first, and arguably the easiest way to change the time of day is to click on Tools, Environment Editor. It will open a new window dedicated completely to the environment settings. You can change the color of the sun, depth of field, filters, sun direction, sun ray effects, ocean fog, and so much more. But we aren't going to focus on those today. Expand the window to show more and look at the bottom of the window. You will see Start, Current, Speed, Force Sky Update, and End. We are going to only focus on the current option at the moment. Change it from 12 to, say, 18. Immediately, you will see the sky change to a more dusk time setting, which coincides with 18, or 6 o'clock p.m. Save the environment editor settings changes by clicking on the floppy disk icon, and we can move on to the next method. Before closing the environment editor, take a look at the left-hand side of the screen. You will notice a file view pane. It shows a directory tree for where the file is stored. It is stored in the libs folder, which has a subfolder called environment presets, which houses our levelsname.xml file. And this, of course, leads us directly to method number 2. Go ahead and close the environment editor. Navigate to the folder you created in your project and click on Assets. Click on Levels, and then Example. This will open the directory that stores our level information. Click on Level Data, and this is where all the XML data that makes up our level is stored. The XML file we want to modify is named Time of Day. Double-click on it to open it up. I will be using Notepad++ for this. We can see time is set at 18, which is what we did with the environment editor. Let's change that to be 15 to represent 3 o'clock p.m. and save the file. Now, we can obviously see that the level did not update in the editor as it was left open. Just click on File, Open, and select the level. We can see that the level has the proper time of day settings now. Let's move on to our third option, via code. Create a new script and call it Time of Day. Double-click on the script to open it up in Visual Studio. In the onGameplayStart method, we are going to write a single line of code. Write engine console.execute string. This tells the engine that we are going to execute a console command to it. This method has three ways you can use it. You can just issue the text command to it. You can issue the command and specify whether it will execute in silent mode, or you can issue the command and specify whether it will execute in silent mode and if it should defer execution. Silent mode set to true means that it will silence the execution of the command from the logs. Defer execution set to true means that it will execute the command on the next frame. Set to false will execute the command immediately. Good information for the average user to know, I should think. Add a string in the parameter of the method with the value being e_timeofday, add a space, and write 24. We are specifying the time of day will be at 24, or midnight. In the environment editor, it will show up as 2359. Go back to the CryEngine editor window and click on Create Object. Select Empty Entity and drag and drop it anywhere in your level. Select that entity and click Add Component and select our time of day script to add to it. Now, obviously, the time of day will not shift yet as the code has not been executed. So click on the play button to execute the method. You should see the same result as what I have here. Immediately on pressing the play button, the sky shifts from 3 p.m. to midnight. You can even exit from play mode and the results will still be in effect. In C++, you would have to close the editor for any change to code you make. The code for C++ looks a little different from what we just did in C#. So let's create a C++ project and look at how it should be done there. Open the project directory of the C++ project created. Where you see game, right-click on it and select Generate Solution. When asked, click OK on Generate for Visual Studio 2017 with 64-bit build options. Navigate inside the Solutions folder, drill down into Win64 folder, and double-click to open game.sln. In the game directory of the Visual Studio solution, expand the Components folder and open player.cpp. Scroll down to the process event method in the player.c++ file. Go to the entity_event_start_game case underneath of revive add g environment member arrow operator p console member arrow operator execute string with the string parameter set to be e_timeofday with space in between and the number 24. This tells the game environment to use the console variable to execute the string specified, which will change the time of day to be 2359, or 1159 p.m. Open the C++ project in the CryEngine editor and load your level. You'll see that the level currently has the time of day set to be 12 o'clock. Exit from the CryEngine editor, pull Visual Studio back up, and click Build. Depending on your system and the number of threads it can handle simultaneously, it will determine how long it will take to build the project. Open the CryEngine editor up again and load the level. Press the play button and the time of day will update to 2359. Or 11:59 p.m. Save and exit from the C++ project and open the C# project back up. Now we can move on to the last, but certainly not least, method. I would be remiss to include how to do it in flow graphs, even though Crytek has covered it in their tutorials. For the sake of covering all bases, I must do it here as well. First things first, remove the script we created for handling time of day from the entity it was attached to. In the flow graph tab in Properties, select Open and press the OK button. Click on Tools and Flow Graph to open the flow graph editor window. Select your entity in the graph section of the flow graph editor window. Now we can add our nodes. The first node to add is our start node. To do this, right-click in the graph and select Add Start Node. Now we need a time of day node to be added. Right-click in the graph and highlight Add Node. Look for and highlight time, and then select time of day. Put the line from output in the game start node to set time in the time of day node. Click on Force Update and in the Properties tab in the top right, put a check mark to set it to be true. The last thing to do is double click on time and set it to be 8 for 8 o'clock a.m. Click on File and save all external graphs. Now click on the Play button and you will see the sky update once again. And there you have it! All four ways you can update the time of day settings in CryEngine. I hope you found this video useful, no matter how you work with CryEngine. I want to give a warm shout out to my Patreon supporters. Ethan, Roomy Rooms, Matt Coburn, and Kupala. Thank you very much for your continued support. It means a lot to me, guys.